Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week.
We like to think that we have seen and know about everything that goes on our planet. While it is true that we were able to find out valid explanations to a lot of mysteries that we came across on Earth over the years, we still do not know nearly everything. You might have the misconception that our planet has become a boring place, but you will be amazed after watching this video, as we will show you 10 of the most unusual things on Earth that you will probably be seeing for the first time. 10 things that you will see for the first time in your life. Number 10. Albino turtle with an exposed heart. It is not often that you are able to see the beating heart of a living organism without the use of advanced medical technology. However, this extremely rare phenomenon of a turtle named Hope was born with her heart outside of the correct cavity, which allows the heart to be seen functioning from the outside. The condition is so rare that there was no name given for this incident in veterinary science yet. Although this condition was never seen before in turtles, one human in every 126,000 is born with a similar disease called ectopia cordis. The albino pink-belly side-neck breed now resides in New Jersey with an animal lover named Mike Aquilina. He maintains an Instagram account for the tiny living thing, where it is followed by hundreds of thousands of Instagram users. He inspires people with consistent posts of Hope, where he is often seen to claim the little creature to be fragile but fearless. In spite of her condition, Hope lives a healthy life and can be observed to swim, eat, and play around with ease while providing her numerous followers with hope. Number 9. Ghost plant. Monotropa uniflora is often widely recognized by its various other names, such as ghost plant, ghost flower, or the Indian pipe. It gets its name uniflora as the plant produces a single flower. These plants look more like a mushroom or fungus rather than a flowering plant, mainly because of their pale white coloration. Some of these have also been reported to have been found in pink, salmon, and even reddish shades. The Indian pipe is classified as a perennial plant, as it lives for more than 2 years. It is mostly found in the temperate regions of Asia, North America, and the northern regions of South America. The most interesting fact about this plant is that it does not require any sunlight. Instead, it gets the required energy, such as carbon, from the host plant that it is growing on. While many claim the plant to be parasitic, the relationship is rather mutual, as the Indian pipe produces and provides the host with much-needed nutrients that assist the plant in its nourishment. Number 8. Purple grape agate. The purple grape agate is a fascinating variation of mineral that is mostly found in the Indonesian island of Sulawesi. As you can already guess from its name, the crystal has a purple color and is found in spherical shapes. However, you will still be left astonished once you get to look at one up close because of an almost identical resemblance of the crystals to grapes. On top of that, these minerals are commonly found in small clusters, which look even more like a bunch of grapes. You may not be able to differentiate between a cluster of this mineral and a bunch of grapes from a distance, but upon looking closely, it can be easily recognized. This is because the spheres of the crystal are recognizably smaller than those of the grapefruit. While the purple ones are the most common and look the most like grapes, many specimens of these crystals have been discovered in other colors, such as white, blue, green, and gray. Number 7. Whoosh Passage Portal. You have probably heard about many famous water parks with exciting water rides, but have you ever heard of one that was built for salmon? Although it was obviously not built for the amusement of fish, the salmon cannon, or fish tube, was built by the US-based company named Whoosh Innovations to solve fish migration problems. Many fish find it difficult and stressful to travel to their natural migration and spawning grounds, especially due to the construction of dams. The new technology makes this much easier for the fish, as it takes only seconds rather than days for the marine animals to reach their spawning ground. This safe form of transportation involves air pressure being used to send salmon and other fish whizzing over dams. In fact, many people have shown interest in riding the Whoosh Passage Portal themselves. Number 6. Gorilla made of nails. We know about several various architectural phenomena that are truly visually majestic. While you are probably thinking about buildings, we are actually talking about the many different animal structures built by talented architects. You might have seen or heard about plenty of such structures, but it is very unlikely that you have heard about the amazing life-size gorilla made completely out of nails. This creative piece of work was done by a Pennsylvanian artist named Bill Secunda. The silverback gorilla was made out of more than 500 pounds or 227 kilograms of common hardware store nails. The talented welder is also known for his other wonderful works, where he constructed many other animals using nails. Number 5. Scream mask on butterfly wings.
When we hear about butterflies, we often have a positive image in our head of a harmless, colorful, winged flying insect that is part of nature's most beautiful wonders. On the other hand, when we hear about ghosts, we often get a spooky feeling, and the word itself has a negative ring to it. There is no way we could imagine these two things together. However, nature had its own magical way of combining these two opposites into one astonishing masterpiece. In India, a fascinatingly decorated butterfly was found with designs on its wings that looked identical to the ghost mask from the famous 1996 horror film Scream. The butterfly had a yellow and orange shade of wings with black and white patterns all over the flaps. These black and white decorations formed what looked to be multiple scream masks on the insect's wings. Number 4. Horn House. We often see people collecting items that particularly interest them, such as bottle caps, sneakers, jerseys, and many other things. And whenever we look at a considerably large collection, it is almost always fascinating to watch. However, the antler collection at Jim's Horn House is much more than just fascinating. The antler enthusiast James Phillips, also known as the Antler Man, had been collecting horns since he was a young child. He used to hike the Gallatin Canyon in search of bones shed by mule deer, elk, moose, or whitetails. Over the course of more than 60 years, he collected over 16,000 pieces of antlers of various different shapes and sizes. Not only did he collect them, but also built the horn house in Montana, which looks like an ordinary shed from the outside, but has an inexplicable interior. All of the collected specimens are decorated all over the place, with several of them hanging on the walls or dangling from the ceiling. The house is free to visit for anyone who is interested in taking a look around the marvelous horn residence that Philip spent all his life creating. Number 3. Roadless Town. If you are asked to close your eyes and imagine a town out of a fairy tale, you are most likely to think of a peaceful place with no noise except for nature. The village of Giethorn is the closest thing you will find in the real world that can be defined as a town out of a fairy tale. The whole village has no roads, and anyone who wishes to visit the place has to leave their car outside the town and travel on foot instead. There are canals and bridges all over the village, and whisper boats, which are noiseless boats, can also be used to move around. For this reason, Giethorn is also widely known as the Venice of the Netherlands. This magical town was founded around 1230, and it is so tranquil there that, apparently, the loudest sound you would hear was the quacking of a duck, unless the place is crowded by tourists, of course. Number 2. Underwater Hockey. You are likely to have heard about a number of water sports, such as surfing, water polo, and water skiing, as well as different types of hockey, such as field hockey, street hockey, and ice hockey. Underwater hockey, also known as octopush, is a combination of both these sports, where the players are expected to play hockey underwater. Just like many world-famous games such as cricket and football, this game was also invented by England and was first played in South Sea England in 1954. And, just like other hockey games, there is a puck that is required to be passed around and shot past the opposition's goal line to score a point. The players are not only expected to be excellent swimmers, but are also required to be able to hold their breath for long periods as no additional breathing devices are allowed. While this might be the first time you are hearing about this game, underwater hockey is not too uncommon, as it is played in many countries, including Canada and England, and regular championships are also held. Number 1. Ice Music. Have you ever thought of producing music from ice? Probably not. However, the famous ice sculptor named Tim Linhart came up with the astonishing idea of making a musical instrument out of ice. He carved an upright string bass and was amazed by the melody it was able to produce. And therefore, ice music was created in the Swedish Lapland. He decided to expand his ideas and made many more instruments, such as drum kits, cellos, violins, a xylophone, and even his own invention, the giant Rolandophone. He put together a local orchestra and often performs at his custom-built ice concert hall. The special ice arena is built using two massive spherical igloos that are conjoined to be able to accommodate a maximum audience of 200 people. The concert takes place in the center of the hall, where the two igloos meet, and where the temperature is lowest. The only drawback to this innovative idea of ice music is that the instruments often melt or implode due to the brittleness of the ice. That is all for today's video. Thank you all for watching. While you're here, go ahead and click on one of these two videos on your screen. See you there!